The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 1 through 8, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 10th, 1973, in Stockholm, Sweden.
So, Parabhavastavad. अबोध जातो जावन जिज्ञास आत्म तत्यम जावत क्रियास्तावत इदंग मनो वै कर्मात्मकं जेन शरीर बंध. सो इन द प्रीवियस वर्स ऋषभदेव हैज सेड दैट दिस मैडनेस आफ्टर सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन Nunam Pramatta Kurude. And doing all kinds of sinful activities, this is not good. Actually, we can see I daily say that during talking you should not cut. So, one may argue, especially those who are atheists, that suppose we get a material body and little miserable, what is wrong there? It will be finished. Then there will be no more pains and pleasure. That is the Buddhist theory, that the body is combination of matter, and there is pains and pleasure. So make this body zero. Then there will be no more pains and pleasure. And you will have to accept another body. And so long you shall continue to accept one body after another, the miserable condition of material existence will continue. Then from the beginning it was said that this body, human body, is not to be misused simply for sense gratification, like the dogs and hogs. That was the beginning. So therefore again he says, Parabhavastavadabodhajavato javanna jigyasato atmatattva. These rascals, they do not know that for want of knowledge of the soul, atma-tattva, on the bodily concept of life, whatever they are doing, that is defeat. They are thinking, now by scientific advancement we are able to go to the moon planet. Of course, I do not know whether they can go. Till now, they are not successful, but at least attempting. So, this is our achievement. But Rishabhdev says, that is not your achievement, that is your defeat. It is your defeat. Why defeat? Because you cannot come to the moon planet or sun planet or any other planet like that. You are simply wasting your time. Just try to understand. Suppose you want to go to some foreign country, and if you think that by force, just like in England, some Indians, they come by some, what is called smuggling method. So, that is not allowed. You cannot go. The moon planet, from the Shastra you understand that nobody can go there unless he is fit. Not only moon planet, any other planet, it is said in the Bhagavad Gita, Janti Deva Vrata Deva. These are higher planetary system the demigods did there. So unless you are fit to live with the demigods, you cannot go there. Just like Krishna Loka. Unless you make yourself fit to enter into the Krishna Loka, you cannot go by force. That's not possible. Just like to enter into some foreign country, you have to take visa, you have to take passport, immigration, then you'll be allowed. So such attempt to go there, and even if you go there, you'll be driven away. So what is the use of such attempt? Therefore, this so-called what is called excursion to attempt to go to some planet, you cannot stay there, neither will be allowed to enter. So this endeavor to go there by so-called scientific advancement is simply defeat, because it will not be allowed, neither can go there. Naturally, it is happening, so what they have achieved so far, nothing, no tangible achievement. But they have spent millions of dollars, Russia and America, to go to the moon planet. And even if you go there, but after all, you have to die, you have to give up this body, and after death, you do not know where you will be placed. That is under the nature's hand. You cannot dictate that after death I shall go to that planet or this planet. No. You are completely under the nature's control. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. Unless you are qualified, everyone is ambitious. But does it mean simply by becoming ambitious one can become very rich man or very respectable man? That is not possible. One must qualify himself. So these are futile attempts. You have to act according to the, but they do not believe that there is higher authority. There is judgment, everything they think that it is blind, whatever you like we can do. That is not goal. Parabhava. This is called defeat. Parabhava stavad abhurhuja. So javadna jignasa, so long one is not inquisitive to understand what he is, without understanding his identification, whatever he does, it is defeat. This is the condition. Nobody is interested to know his identity. This is the instruction we get from Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami, when he first approached Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his question was that Kiyami Kano Mare Jape Tapatra. This is a very nice question. Kindly tell me what I am. what I am, and why I am subjected to the threefold miseries of material existence. I do not want all this miserable condition of life, but I am forced to accept them. Therefore, what is my position? Why I am forced to accept? This should be the question. This is called Atmatattva Jignasa inquiry. What I am? Nobody knows what he is. Everyone thinks that I am this body. Therefore, he is abodhajat. From the very birth, he is rascal. He does not know his identity. Somebody is thinking I am American, somebody is thinking I am Englishman, somebody is thinking I am Indian. All these identification are doggish identification. Just the dog is thinking I am this body. The cat is thinking I am this body. Similarly, if a human being thinks like that, that I am this body, then he remains in ignorance. Abodhujata. And if you remain in ignorance, whatever you are acting as your credit, but you are acting in ignorance, therefore the achievement is not achievement, it is defeat. This is to be understood. One should be inquisitive. Just like Sanatana Goswami went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he asked, Sir, let me know what I am. Gramma vyavahare kahaya pandit. In ordinary behavior, people say that I am very learned man. They say, Panditji. The Brahman is addressed in India as Panditji. Panditji means very learned. So, Sanatana Goswami submitted that the general people, they say that I am very learned, but actually I do not know what I am. He admitted. So ask anybody, so-called scholar, doctors, PhD, DSC, just like that Professor Kotaji, he said, after finishing this body, everything is finished. He does not know what he is. This is the position. Therefore, the so-called scholars, learned men, whatever they are doing, they are being defeated because he does not know his identity. Unless you know your identity, then how can you work for the goal of your life? If your identity is mistaken, then whatever you are doing, that is your defeat. Javat kriya astavat idanga mano vai karmatmakam jena sariravandha. Everyone has got different types of mentality. So, karmatmakam means, that is general mentality, that I shall work very nice and I shall get money and I shall enjoy life. This is called karmatmakam. Not only in this life, next life also, they are trying, those who are followers of Vedic ritualistic ceremony by punya-karja. Punya-karja means pious activities. The pious activity, that is also activity. So, according to our philosophy, we are not interested even in pious activity. We are not interested in impious activity, we are not interested even in pious activities. This is our position. Narottamdas Thakur has sung, karma-kanda, gyana-kanda, sakali visare bhanda, amrita boliya jiva khaya, nana jani bhraman kare, kadajya bhakkhan kare. By pious activities, you can get very nice birth, janma isarja suta sri, four kinds of material gain to get birth in a very aristocratic family or rich family, janma isajya, to become very learned scholar, suta, and Sri, very beautiful. Just like you American people or Western people, you are supposed to be very learned, advanced in material science, also good-looking and richer than other countries, janma isajya, or birth in a very powerful nation or family. This can be accepted due to your past pious activities. But suppose you have taken these opportunities for your pious activities and somebody has taken birth in Greenland. What is that, Greenland? Always with snow, and there are so many inconveniences. Or take your birth in Africa. There is no such facilities. They are not very good-looking, not very learned scholars. Not birth is very nice, not aristocracy, not riches, poor. So, from spiritual point of view, both these kinds of facilities or inconvenience are one. Because when you take your birth, you have to enter within the womb of a mother and to stay 10 months in a packed-up condition. Not only 10 months nowadays, it is going on, killing the child within the womb. Even you cannot come out, before your coming out from the womb of your mother, you might be killed by your very mother or father. Because that moment is going on, abortion. So, either you are in the womb of a very rich mother or a poor mother, or in the womb of a black mother or white mother, or a learned mother, a foolish mother, the pains of staying within the mother is the same. It is not that because you are in the womb of a rich mother, therefore there will be no pain of living within the womb. The same pain. So janma, then again, as soon as you accept some material body, you will have to suffer the bodily pains and pleasure. Then at the time of death, the same painful condition. So it doesn't matter whether one is rich, one is poor, the material condition, both of them will have to suffer. The material condition. So, karmātmaka, if you continue to absorb your mind in fruitive activities, that I shall work and I shall get the result and I shall enjoy, this is called karmātmaka. So if you do not fulfill your desire, then nature will give you next life, another body, to fulfill that desire. This is going on. So that, therefore, it is parabhava. Your business is that to know that you are not this body, you are spirit soul, part and parcel of God, Krishna. So your real business is to become Krishna conscious fully and go back to home, back to Godhead, finish this business of repetition of birth and death. But who will understand this? Therefore, it is said, Krishna je bhaje seva rajata. One who has understood what is the meaning of Krishna consciousness movement, he must be very intelligent man. Without being intelligent man, nobody can understand what is the purpose, what is the basic principle of this movement. The basic principle of this movement is to understand Krishna. Janma karma me dibbam ju janati tattva. The result will be, if you understand Krishna, what is Krishna, then the result will be that after giving up this body, you go to Krishna. Janti madjajino pi mam. This devotional service, the worshipping Krishna in the temple to dress him, as I explained, Sri Vigraharadhana Nittanana Singharatana Mandiramanjanadu. All these occupational duties will help you to understand Krishna. Although it is very difficult to understand Krishna, but if you engage yourself in Krishna's service as they are prescribed in the Shastras or by the spiritual master, then Krishna reveals to you what he is, and that is wanted. That is the perfection of your life. As soon as you understand Krishna, then you become fit to go back to home, back to Godhead, and finish this business of repeated birth and death. Māmupita kaunti ya dukkhālayam sāsatam nāpnuvanti. This secret of success people do not know. Neither they can understand. They are not fortunate enough. But it is our duty to push on this movement by superior order. Anyone will take advantage of this movement, he will be saved from this repetition, birth and death. So Rishabdev says that so long one's mind is absorbed in the conception that I shall work as people are doing here, industry, trade, so many things. The real purpose is to gratify senses. See, in this way, if people are engaged, then he is parabhava, he is being defeated. Without understanding Krishna consciousness, without being Krishna conscious, if simply one wastes his time for these fruitive activities, then he is defeated. Evam manakarma vasam prajunte avidvaya. Upadhiyamane. Atman, avidvaya atman upadhiyamane. Pritinna javat mai vasudevi namuchyate deha jogi nata. So everyone is under this impression, wrong conception of life. But he can be saved if he somehow or other becomes a devotee of Vasudeva Krishna. Pritinna javat mai Vasudeva. Vasudevi Bhagavati in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojite Prayojitaha Janayati Asu Vairagam Gyananca Jadahaitakam. Vasudeva, here is the same thing. Mai Vasudeva, Rishabdev is incarnation of Vasudeva. So, in this entanglement of birth and death, if someone comes in contact with devotee, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Latabi, and gets the seed of devotional service, then that is the beginning of being saved from this repetition of birth and death. Just like we are giving opportunities to the people in general, we are opening centers in different parts of the world. What is the purpose? The purpose is to give chance to every man how to become devotee of Vasudeva. Then he will say, Javanna Priti Mahi Vasudeva. Because people are struggling hard in this way, by working hard and getting the result for sense gratification and reputation of birth and death. In this struggle for existence, if somehow or other one gets the seed of devotion and service to Vasudeva, then he said, Javanna Priti Mahi Vasudeva. Evanga manakkarma vasam prajunti avidya atman upadhiyamane pritinnajavat mahi vasudevi namuchati diha yoginata. Unless one becomes Krishna conscious, his reputation of birth and death and contacting another body from one body to another, that will continue. This is the basic principle of Krishna consciousness. Do not misunderstand Krishna consciousness. It is a kind of religious faith. It is a science. How to get release from this repetition of birth and death? This is science. It is not that as people accept a system of religion, or another system of religion, and because a human being is supposed to accept some type of religion. Somebody is Hindu, somebody is Muslim, somebody is Christian. It is not that. It is a science. It is a science we are teaching that somehow or other you enhance your love for God, then you are saved. This is science. And how to enhance that love of God? That is our activities, to rise early in the morning, to offer Mangala Arati, to dress the deity, to offer him nice foodstuff, to observe festivals, writing books, distributing them. These are activities and devotion and service that will save us from this repetition of birth and death. Otherwise, we are doomed. We have to continue this repetition of birth and death. Abhidvaya eva manushadu. This is avidya. By avidya, by misunderstanding, without knowledge, being in ignorance, manushadu, sometimes we are human beings, sometimes cats, sometimes dogs, sometimes demigod. This is going on. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Eirupe brahmanda bhamite kone. We are wandering throughout the whole universe, from one body to another, one planet to another. But somehow or other, if we are fortunate, this fortune is made in this way. Man is the architect of his own fortune. If somebody comes to our contact, if he tries to understand what is this Krishna consciousness, his fortune. Because he'll be saved from the reputation of birth and death. Vidagavacharya says, therefore, Deva Manushadu paradhika deva visishta tena aha ahankara mama upadhiyamane. That I am now American, I am now Englishman. This is ahankara upadhiyamane. Karma vasana mulaya samsitta mane satyatma ni mana karma vasam prajunte vyaparayati purushamiti sesa. Ato javat vasudeve mai priti, priti rupa bhakti nasya tāvat deha yogena na mucchate. Unless we become devotee of Vasudeva Krishna, therefore Krishna personally comes and he says, sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam vraja. That is for your interest. Krishna says that you surrender unto me, it is not Krishna's interest. If you surrender not interest, Krishna does not do anything. He is omnipotent. He can create millions of devotees like you by his desire. He doesn't canvass, he is not canvassing that you become my devotee and I shall be very rich. No. Not the purpose. It is for your interest. Something. If you become a devotee of Vasudeva, then you are saved from this imputation of birth and death. It is not Krishna's interest. It is Krishna's interest in this way, because you are part and parcel, you are son of Krishna. Krishna as the ahama bija pudapita, as the father, rich father, he does not like to see that his son will become a crazy, mad fellow and loiter in the street. He doesn't want it. But if you do not come back to home, there is no loss of the father. But if you go back to home of a rich father, then it is your interest. It is your interest. So Krishna is canvassing sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam vraja. It is for our interest. So those who are fortunate, they will accept this offer of Krishna and ata javad vasudeva mai priti priti rupa bhakti. Priti means bhakti. Priti means love. So there is priti sandarbha by Srila Jiva Goswami. How one can become lover of Krishna? Sat sandarbha. He has written six theses. One of them is the priti sandarbha, Krishna sandarbha, Bhagavat sandarbha, six sandarbha. Very highly philosophical books. So this priti means bhakti. Bhakti is not official transaction. Bhakti means priti, real love. When I actually love Krishna, that is called priti. Just like we love our beloved, our child, our husband, our wife, that is also not love, that is a temporary sentiment. Actual love is possible with Krishna. That is actual love. Once you love Krishna, it cannot be broken at any time. It cannot be broken. Any circumstances. So therefore, somehow or other, we have to jena tena prakarena mana Krishna nibesayet. Somehow or other, you just engage yourself in loving Krishna. That is the success of life. न केवलं देहयोगमात्रमपि तु अनर्थान् तरतीत्याह जदेति सार्थे स्वस्य पुरुषार्थभूते सात्म परमात्म देहसम्बन्धप्रयुक्ते विपश्चित् विवेकी सन् यदा सहसा न पश्यति tadāsu pumān gata-smṛti. This is very important. Śabda says, jadāna paśyati ajathā guṇī hāṁ sārthi pramatya sahasā vipaśyati. So, we have to become intelligent. That guṇeha, guna. Guna means these three gunas, goodness, three modes of material nature. Everyone is trying to love one of these three gunas, goodness, passion and ignorance. That is material existence. Somebody is trying to become brahmana. That is goodness. and somebody is trying to become a kshatriya, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, these are under the influence of different modes of material nature. So even one is Brahmana, he is also under the grip of material nature. And what to speak of, one is a Shudra or less than a Shudra. Everyone is trying to improve himself under the influence of certain modes of material nature. So when one becomes vipastit, viveki, vipastit means enlightened, that these my activities under the influence of different modes of material nature, this is waste of time. Even if I become a brahmana, that is also waste of time. And what to speak of, if I become a kshatriya, passionate, then this vaishya, this mercantile class of men, they are passionate and ignorance mixture. They are very active. I am very running, I am very busy. But running here and there in ignorance, just like you see the monkey. Monkey is always very busy. But what is the meaning of his busyness? He is in ignorance. As soon as a monkey comes, we have no such disturbance. In India, as soon as a monkey comes, everyone wants to drive him away. Because he has come to become business and to make some loss, that's all. That is his business. Wherever you see, he'll move like this. He is not at all silent. He's always active. But because he is monkey is a symbol, our ass. They are symbol of ignorance. Therefore, such kind of business is useless. It is simply harmful. So, when one comes to understand that this is my business, this is my goodness, everything, it is all useless unless I become attached. I am a devotee of Vasudev, Krishna. All these attempts are simply futile attempts. That is enlightenment. When one understands, yes, my only business is to surrender to Krishna, to love Krishna, then he is to be understood, he is enlightened, he is educated. Eirupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagavan. That is false. Yadana pasyati ajitha guniha sarthi pramatta. He does not know his interest. Nati vidu sartha gatingi Vishnu. They do not know that my sartha, my interest, my goal of life is to love, to find out God and to love Him. That is my real interest. So as so long one is not enlightened to that standard of life, then he is defeated. Then how is defeated? Gata smriti vinnati tatra tapan asyadva maithunna magaram agga. He remains agga, foolish. And what is his happiness? His happiness is sex life. That's all. That is his happiness. Maithunna magaram. He is in the prison house of this material nature. But he does not know that I am in prison. He is simply enjoying the three things, udaram bharita, the tongue, the belly and the genital. That is stated here. Gata smriti vindati, and to enjoy this material, he has to undergo so much tribulation. Tapan vindati. Therefore, Govinda Das says, Sita yatapa vata parishana edinna jamini jagire bifale sevinu kripana durajana chapala sukhala balagire. In this country there is snowfall. Still people have to go to work very hard day and night. But why? Why they are accepting such hard labor? Somebody is coming from India. In this country, the climate is not very suitable. in comparison to India, but they have come here to work hard. Why? That's sex pleasure, that's all. You'll get money and you'll have home and sex pleasure, or tongue pleasure. So, that would be said, Gata Smriti, he is forgotten. His own business he has forgotten, but he is entrapped by a process of sense gratification, although it is very great hardship and miserable condition, but he is satisfied because the sense gratification is there. Gata smriti tatra tapan asadya maithunna magaram agya. Because he is foolish, therefore he likes to be imprisoned simply for sense gratification. You know, the elephant is captured for sense gratification. You know that? Elephant is captured, a big elephant to capture, it is very difficult. But a female elephant goes there and he comes for sex, and the female elephant goes forward. Then she brings in a place where there is a big pit, and he falls down, the male elephant, and then he becomes captured. Yes. These are the nature's example. How far? And not only sex, just like the bees, they enter into the lotus flower for eating honey, and they're enjoying in the meantime the lotus flower petals become closed. So he becomes entrapped, cannot come out, dies. The fish, how the tackle? You know, you have seen the, what is called, tackle?
Fisherman, tackle,
yes. What is that? And there is a small, attractive foodstuff, and the fish comes, and as soon as it swallows, mask is captured. Similarly, the deer, they are also captured by the hunter. He plays nice flute, and the deer stand up. They are very much fond of music. So as soon as they stand up, enter. So the one animal are lower than human being, they have got one sense very strong. Someone's the ear, someone's the nose, someone's the tongue, someone's the genital, in this way. But they have got one sense strong. And we, the so-called civilized man, our six senses are all strong. So what is the position? So unless one becomes Krishna conscious, he is doomed. So many senses, tongue is taking into the hotel, ear is taking to the musical, eye is taking the beautiful thing to see. In this way, we are embarrassed in so many ways. That is called maithunna magara magga. He has forgotten his real business, but he is entrapped in a pot or in a place where sense gratification is very good. Pungshan sriyami thunibhavami tat sayur mithari dayaganti mahu atak grihachi tusutapvittai. So this mithunibhava, the sense enjoyment is very strong. There are two sexes, male and female, and each one of them are attracted by sense gratification. In this way, atha grihachetu sutapta vritti, then they become attached to griha, because they must live in an apartment, they must have some land, grihachetra, everywhere there is going on. In this way, they become entrapped. And Krishna consciousness, SUBBED, means, but those who are Krishna conscious, for them it is not, they are vigilant, that my real business is Krishna consciousness. But it is a license given to me for sense gratification, for grihastha, but we should not forget our real business and entrapped in this material nature. That should be our business. Thank you very much.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 15th of April, 1975, in Hyderabad, India.
Grihastha or Shudra or Brahmana, they are situated on the transcendental platform. So such person described here, because the recommendation is Mahat Seva. So it does not mean Mahat is only to be found among the sannyasis or fire circle brahmanas. No. Mahat can be found in other circle also. But what is the qualification? The qualification is Jiva Mahishe Kritasho Hridartha. His only business is to keep friendly relationship with Krishna. That is the first qualification. The first class example is Arjuna. He was a military man, a politician, and grihastha, kshatriya, not Brahman, not sannyasi, but still Krishna accepts him. Sakha chiti. But you are my dear friend, bhaktosi sakhachit. You are not only my devotee, you are my best friend, Krishna says. Although he is grihastha, a military man, and kshatriya, still Krishna accepts him, that I shall speak to you the mystery of Bhagavad Gita, because you are my dear friend, and bhakta. Bhaktosi sakhachit rahasam etad uttamam. Krishna also wants somebody friendly. It doesn't matter whether he is a sannyasi or grihastha. So any grihastha whose only aim is how to keep friendship with Krishna, he is also Mahatma. He also Mahatma. Because the recommendation, Mahasse Bapa, Dharmahud Bhimukti. One has to take shelter of a Mahatma and serve him with surrender, then his path of liberation will be open. So, if somebody says, I think the other day somebody was questioning, that if I cannot contact sannyasi because I am grihastha, I am family man, so how my path of liberation will be open. Yes, that is possible, provided you find amongst your society a person like this, Jiva Moishi Kritasa Hidartha. If you can find out amongst your associate a person who is only dedicated to Krishna, you can associate with him, then your path of liberation will be open. So that symptoms are described here. Janeshu jivamayise kritasau hidartha janeshu dhiham bharavartikeshu griheshu jayatma jaratimasu na priti jukta. Janeshu dhiham bharavartikeshu.
generally people, they are interested how to maintain this body, because they are in bodily concept of life. Just like we pass through the streets, there are so many shopkeepers, and they are all decorating their shop to supply the needs of the body. Cloth shop, tailor shop, wine shop, this shop, that shop. But what are these shops? Deham bharavartikesu. They are simply interested in maintaining this body. That's all. This is only business. In the big, big cities, you'll find the business is going on. How to maintain this body? There is advantage. As you look just like a human being, not something advertised. So, that is going on. Our business at the present moment, in conditioned life, nidra hyate naktram. At night we sleep. And babayana cha babaya. Babayana means sex. At night our business is to sleep and to indulge in sex. In this way we are wasting time, night. And daytime, viva charte hayarajan kutumma bharanenava. And at the daytime, we are very busy going this side, that side. Why? To get some money. Divacha arthe yaya. Designing where I shall get money, where I shall get money. Divacha arthe yaya. And as soon as I get money, I spend it kutumbha bharane nava. To maintain our family. So, where is time for Krishna consciousness? There is no time, sir. So, one should not be interested in that way. Therefore it is said that deham bharabhartikesu. Those who are busy only for maintenance of this body, to such person he is not interested. Na priti yukta. This is the sign. He may be a grihastha. It does not matter. But he is interested with Krishna's business, not deham bharabhartikesu. Those who are interested with this body only, with them, he has no interest. This is the sign. That is also Mahatma. Jiva maise kritaso hidartha. His only business is how to keep fancy with Krishna. That is his only business. That is Mahatma. And so far, janesu, people in general, were simply interested how to maintain this body. Janesu diham bharavartikesu. And then what about his family? Yes, griheshu, at home. Jaya, jaya means wife. Jaya, atmaja means children. Griheshu jaya atma, jarati matsu. And business about earning money, na priti yukta. He is not interested. Although he is at home, he is not interested at home. Therefore, generally, devotees, they become very reluctant in the interest of maintaining family, children, wife. Simply, as far as possible, duty, so much interested, not anymore. These are the signs. If you want to find out a grihastha mahatma, then he has got his family, he has got his children, he has got his wife, he has got his business, he has got to meet so many other people. But there he is not at all interested, simply behavior, officer. Yes, yes, it is all right. Yes, it is all right. What you say, it is all right. But I am not interested. This is called disinterest. People are generally very much interested in these things. So, if you want to find out a mahatma within the society, not as a renowned sannyasi, then these are the symptoms. There are other symptoms. Nunam pramatta kruti vikarma, that we shall describe later on. These are the general symptoms of a mahatma, grihastha. He is not interested in this bodily concept of life or maintaining very opulently his family members or talking very seriously with persons who are simply materially interested, dehambhara, just to maintain this body. Of course we require to maintain this body. He is not neglectful. There is no question of negligence. He takes care of his children, of his wife, everything, but without any attachment. That is recommended by the Goswamis, that anāsaktasya viṣaya yathāraṁ upajanyato. You give education to your children, that is required. You maintain your wife, that is also required. No negligence, but no attachment at the same time. No attachment that I shall sacrifice everything for my wife and children and home. That is not a mahatma's business, because he knows that he cannot improve the destiny. Everybody has got his body with certain destiny already settled that you cannot change. Otherwise, everyone is trying to become very rich, very important. There is no scarcity of endeavor, but not that everyone is becoming like that. That is called destiny. So those who are believers in the Shastras, believers in the Supreme Lord, they believe in destiny also. Therefore Shastra says, tasyaiva arthe prajateta kovida na labhate jas bhramatam uparjata. We should try for advancing our Krishna consciousness. That is our main business. Tasyaiva heta prajateta kovida. Kovida means very expert. He should try for advancing in Krishna consciousness, not for material advancement. This is civilization. That is, we have already discussed. Nāyāṁ deva deva bhājāṁ ni loke kastān kāmān arahati vīr bhujāṁ je. If you think that if I work very hard, then I shall improve my position, that is not possible. Your position is already fixed up. Then shall I not try for my happiness? Yes. That is implied in the Shastra. Kallabhate dukkhavat annata sukham. You do not try for distress of life. Why does it come? You do not ask God, please give me distress. Nobody asks. But why distress comes? Similarly, if you do not pray for happiness, if you have got happiness in your destiny, it will come as the distress comes. Tallabhati dukkhavat annata sukham. So don't be misled by so-called happiness and distress. It is already fixed up. Simply try for advancing in Krishna consciousness. That is real business. Tasyaiva heta prajati tukhavi. That business can be done very perfectly well when mahasevadharamahur vimukte, when you associate with mahatma, it doesn't matter whether he is a sannyasi or grihastha. He must be mahatma. Mahatma means one who has got relationship with Krishna. That is described in the Bhagavad. Mahatmanastumang pratha daivi prakriti masrita bhajanti ananna manasu. That is mahatma. You cannot stamp anybody and become a mahatma. No. Mahatma's sign is Mahatmanastumang pratha daivi prakriti masrita bhajanti ananna manasu. He has no other business. Simply, he has only one business, how to please Krishna. That is Mahatma. Anukullena, just like Arjuna did. Arjuna did not try to fight. He is completely denied. He set aside his arrows and bows, became very morose. And then he asked Krishna, "I am now puzzled. You can give me instruction. What is my duty? Because tatpanna dosa apahata sabhava. Actually, it is my duty that I am Kshatriya and there is fight, battlefield. I should take advantage of it. But still, tatpanna dosa apahata sabhava. I am going against my nature, so I do not know what to do. Please instruct. Shishasteham sadhimang prapannam." So, actually, Arjuna was not willing to fight because he is a Vaishnava. He does not want to kill, even if he was put into so many difficulties. That was his attitude. So his decision was that he would not fight. But for the sake of Krishna, when he understood that Krishna wants this fight, Krishna said finally, "Nimitta mātra bhava sabbasāci." Don't think that these people who have come here will go back home. They will be killed here. That is my plan. You simply become an instrument so that you may take the credit. I shall be happy. But they are already finished. This is my plan. So when he understood that Krishna wants me to fight, took the credit of becoming victorious. So he doesn't care for credit, but he understood that this is my duty to please Krishna. Then when Krishna asked him, "What is your decision?" he said, "Yes, karishye vachanam tava, I shall fight." And he fought. This is called kritasauhidartha. For Krishna's sake, they can do anything. There are many other devotees also. There's the gopis. For Krishna's sake, they sacrifice everything. Their reputation, their family, their husband, their father, their brother. No. Krishna is now playing on his flute. He wants to dance with us. Let us go. Father is asking, "Where you are going?" Brother is, "Where you are going?" "How are you going to Krishna?" So, this is called Krishna consciousness. Jiva maishi krita sauhidar. One is not interested in anything else. He is only interested in Krishna. Anukullena Krishna anusilanam. To serve Krishna as he desires. So, as he desires, if we have no relationship with Krishna, no connection with Krishna, how we can understand as he desires? Yes, that we'll have. Krishna is within you. Ishvara sarva-bhutanam niddeshe arjuna tisthati. As soon as you become sincere, if you are qualified to serve Krishna, then Krishna will dictate from within, "Do like this. Buddhi yugam dadami tam jinamam upajantite. To whom? Tesam nittabhijuktanam bhajatam pritipurvatam." One who is engaged in loving service of Krishna, and Krishna is very expert, he can understand how you want to serve him, with a motive or without motive. When he understands, then he personally gives you dictation. "You do like this, you do like that." So that is Krishna's friendship. Krishna is always available. Krishna can be seen 24 hours, provided you elevate to the position how to talk with Krishna, how to see Krishna, how to act for Krishna. It is not very difficult. So, this symptom is described how even a grihastha can become fully Krishna conscious. The negative side is described that he is not interested with this worldly, so-called advancement of social position or advancement of economic problem. So many things they have created. These are described here. Griheshu jayatma jaratimassu. Jaratimassu, na priti yukta javadatthasya loka. neither neglectful, as far as possible, javadartha, not too much overwhelmed. Because after all, this is temporary. Our so-called society, friendship, love in this material world, they are called illusory, phenomenal. Therefore, Shankaracharya says jagat mithya. He says little bluntly. But actually, it has no meaning, because this social condition of life is existent so long this body is there. As soon as I change my body, even in this country, we are very much fond of our country, Janani Janmabhumishta Sargadapi Gariyasi. But the country is so ungrateful. Suppose there are many vivid examples. Mahatma Gandhi, he worked so much for his country, the result was that he was killed by his countrymen. So, just see the example. So, in this material life, you will never be able to make anyone happy by your activities. That is not possible. Neither you will be happy. Kamadina kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesha. Tishangamayina karuna jata natrapa nobo shanti. That is the intelligence. That I have served the so-called society, friendship and love, just to serve my own lusty desires. That's all. Kamadina kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesha. Everyone is serving the so-called societies and for his own satisfaction, sense gratification. Nobody wants to serve anyone. He wants to serve himself. That is the position, real position. So in this way, if we spoil our life, we are serving, but serving our senses, lusty desires. We have to change this mode of service to serve Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness. We have to serve. We cannot become master. That is not possible. As soon as you become master, you will be killed. But that is also false position. We cannot become master. We are servant. But instead of serving Krishna, we are serving Maya. That is our position. So we have to change this position. Instead of serving Maya, we have to transfer our service to Krishna. That is perfection of life. Thank you very much. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhaktosi, priyose, you are my dear friend, and friend at the same time devotee. So, rahasyam etad uttamam. Bhagavad Gita is a mystery, rahasyam, and uttamam, transcendental. So without becoming a devotee of Krishna, nobody can understand Bhagavad Gita. The kormi, jnani, yogi, they cannot understand Bhagavad Gita. Otherwise, Krishna would have instructed Bhagavad Gita to many kormis, jnanis, yogis, they are present. But he knows it well. These kormis, jnanis, yogis, they cannot understand Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, he said to his devotee and friend, bhaktosi, priyosi. So in order to understand Bhagavad Gita, one has to come to this position to become a devotee of Krishna. It is a business between Bhagavan and bhakta. Just like if you go to the marketplace, if some merchant is talking with some broker or somebody about business, he is talking about that business. That is concluded. Similarly, Bhagavad Gita is spoken by Bhagavan and it is heard by the bhakta. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, there is no other business than bhakti. There is no other business. Karma, jnana, yoga, they are described, but with an aim to culminate in bhakti, just like karma. Krishna says, yat karosi, yat asnasi, yat tapasasi, kurusyatat madarpanam, give it to me. This is bhakti. So far, jnanis are concerned. Krishna concludes, bhaunam janmanamante jnanavan maha prapadyate. Jnanis, after many births, cultivation of knowledge, when he actually begins to become a bhakta, then his perfection is there. Bhaunam janmanamante jnanavan maha prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samatma sudilla. This is for the jnanis. And for the kurmis, yat karosi, whatever you do, the result, you give it to me. That means bhakti misra karma, jnana misra bhakti. And for the yogis, he says, yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana sadhyavan bhajate jumang samijukta tamo. The first class yogis, who is always thinking of me, he is first class. Yogi's business is to see God within the heart. That is real yogi. Dhyanavasthita tadgatena manasa pashyanti yang yogino. Yogi's business is to see in meditation always Krishna or Vishnu within the heart. That is real yogi. Dhyanavasthita, by meditation one has to see continually, that is called samadhi. Yogi namapi sarvesam madgata antaratmana sadhyaman bhajate jumang samijuktatam. His first class yogi. So, everything is there ending in bhakti. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, the only talk is about bhakti in a different way, either through karma yoga, or jnana-yoga, or hatha-yoga, the point is how to become a devotee. And at the end, he concludes, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam vraja. This is the conclusion of it. So these things cannot be understood by anyone who is not a devotee. Without being devotee, you cannot understand. Therefore, there are so many, the politicians, the scholars, they are commenting Bhagavad Gita in so many ways. But they are misled. Because they are not devotees of Krishna, they cannot poke their nose in the Bhagavad Gita. It is not possible. So Arjuna was bhakta. Therefore Bhagavad Gita was spoken to him, not to a yogi, not to a karmi, not to a jnani. This is the answer.
But in another place in the Gita, twice it is mentioned, Sreya Swa Dharma Parat Dharma Kayoha. One should perform his own duty rather than another's duty.
Yes. I may say many things to you, but when I say something directly, do it. Your first duty is to do that. You cannot argue, sir, you said me like this before. No, that is not your duty. What I say now, you do it. That is obedience. You cannot argue. Of course, Krishna never said anything contradictory. But if anyone thinks foolishly that Krishna said something contrary, no, that is not. You could not understand. So even though you could not understand, you take my direct orders now. Sarva dhanman parityajya mama. That is your business. The master says like that, and the servant's business is to accept it as it is, without any argument. That's all right.
Are not all the poor, the miserable, and the weak God? Why not worship the living God first?
Who is living God? Who is living God? That he has not mentioned? Poor? Poor is God? Then why rich is not God? If you have so broad vision, that you see God everywhere. So why you make distinction between poor God and rich God? Why you make distinction? If poor is God, the rich is also God. Pannita samadarshana. If you have got so broader vision, then why you distinguish between poor and rich? A pandit, a learned scholar, vidya vinaya sampanne brahmani gavi hastini suni cheta sapaki cha pandita samadarshana. Samadarshi means he has no distinction. Why you should make distinction between poor and rich? That is samadarshi. As soon as you make distinction, then your vision is imperfect. Brahma bhuta prasannatma na sochati na kankhati samas sarveshu bhuteshu samata. Not that I distinguish between this particular class to another particular. That is not Brahma darshan, neither it is samadarshan.
You said that Lord Krishna has many opulences, but in chapter 13, verse 15, he says that he is nirguna. How to reconcile this statement?
What does he mean by nirguna? Let him explain first of all. What is nirguna? What does he mean by nirguna? Nirguna guna bhakti cha. He is, Krishna is described, nirguna guna bhakti cha. He is nirguna, at the same time enjoyer of gunas. What is that enjoyer of guna and nirguna? Can you explain? Nirguna means one who does not live under the condition of material gunas. Satagun, rajagun, tamagun. Transcendental, that is called nirguna. But nirguna does not mean that he has no transcendental qualities. That's like Krishna is bhaktavatsala. That is his guna. But that is not material guna. That is spiritual guna. Krishna is nirguna means he is not controlled by the material qualities. But he has got innumerable spiritual qualities. That is called guna bhakti. So, unless we understand the distinction between matter and spirit, we cannot understand what is the meaning of nirguna. That is not possible.
In India, there are many swamis who claim themselves to be Krishna. How to protect them?
Many Swamis?
To claim to be Krishna. Or to detect
them. Let them prove that he is Krishna. If you are foolish, then they will accept. If you are intelligent, then you will ask him, first of all, leave the Govardhan Hill. Then you become Krishna. Otherwise, you are a rascal, I kick you on your face. This is our verse. We do not accept these rascals as Krishna. We want to test, first of all, that you are Krishna. Why should we accept a rascal as Krishna unless he proves himself that he is Krishna? Krishna lifted Govardhan Hill when he was 7 years old. What he has done? That we shall accept him, Krishna? Don't be foolish. First of all, let him prove that he is Krishna. Test him, then accept.
Why at the time of death the name of God does not come to the tongue?
Because you are not practiced. You practice to chant Hare Krishna, at the time of death it will come. Abhyasa yoga yuktena chitasa nanagamina. That is advised. You practice it and you will remember sada tadabhava bhavi. If you practice 24 hours Krishna, 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 then at the time you chant Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Otherwise there is no possibility. Sada tadabhava bhavi. So we have to practice. That is natural. If you always think of something, at the time of death you will think like that. So you think of Krishna, manmana bhava mad bhakta madhyaji mahagana. Therefore Krishna is mame vaishyasi asangsa. You simply adopt these four principles. Always think of me. become my devotee and offer obeisances unto me, manmana bhava madhyaji, worship me. You do these four things, then mame vaishyasi yasamusaya. Without any doubt, you are coming to me. Why don't you do these four things? Very easy things. It is very difficult to constantly remember Krishna. You can do it. You are remembering something. Your mind is occupied always with something. Just practice to occupy the mind with Krishna. That's all. Where is the difficulty? Manmana bhava mad bhakta madhyali mana namaskar. Everything is there. You practice it. Don't later. Mana Krishna padaravinda, Maharaj Ambarish. He was a great emperor of this world. But his mind was fixed up on the lotus feet of Krishna. Savai mana Krishna padaravindayo vachangsi vaikuntha gunanubannan. When you talk, he'll talk about Krishna only. You practice. You see Krishna's picture, Krishna's deity. You hear Krishna's topics, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavat. In this way, engage all your senses. Your seeing power, your hearing power, your talking power, your eating power, your sleeping power, everything, if you make Krishna conscious, then generally, or automatically, you remember at the time of death Krishna. And as soon as you remember Krishna, Anti Narayana Smriti, then your life is perfect. There is no difficulty. Simply you have to practice. Abhyasa yoga yukti na cetasa nanagana. Don't allow your mind to go astray. Then everything is all right.
When you said that everyone is destined to a particular goal, then where is the question of preaching Krishna consciousness?
Therefore I say, tasyaiva heta prajate taka. You should try only for Krishna consciousness. Other things are destined. You did not hear it properly. That you should not try for anything else, because that is already destined. If you want success, then simply try for Krishna consciousness. That is one. Tasyaiva heta prajate taka vidha. Nalabhate bhramatama parajata. We did not try in our other life, other than human life, we did not try it. We simply tried for eating, sleeping, mating, and defending animal life. So if you do the same thing again and do not take to Krishna consciousness, then you are losing your time. Therefore it is advised, you should try only for Krishna consciousness, not for other things. They are already destined. This is instruction.
What would be the result if all the people became devotees of Krishna Chaitanya?
A very good result. He is lamenting that he doesn't want this good result. That everyone will become Krishna consciousness. There is a story in this connection. There was a hut, a fair, a market. So many people came there. And one old lady began to cry, where shall I give them place? So many people have come here. She began to cry. Then her son said, my mother, see in the evening, you don't worry about giving them place. So in the evening, she saw everyone has gone. Similarly, in due course of nature's activities, prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa, everything will go nicely. You haven't got to be worried. You better be worried. Have to develop your Krishna consciousness. Other things will go on. And what is the harm there? If all people become Krishna conscious and go back to home, back to Godhead, what is the harm there? Do you mean to say to remain here in this material existence and suffer threefold miseries? Is that very good business? That will not happen. Don't be worried. Krishna consciousness is not so cheap. Only a few fortunate people will take it. Others will remain. Don't worry.
How is it that there are different types of religions in the world?
There is no religion. This is manufactured religion. Real religion is to surrender to Krishna. Sarvadharmān parityaja. That was his advice, that you give up all these so-called religions. Sarvadharma. You become surrendered to Krishna. That is real religion. All other cheating religion, that's all. Dharmanta sākṣāt bhagavat pranīt. Just like there may be so many laws, but the real law is what is given by the government. Similarly, there may be so many so-called religious systems, but the real religious system is what is spoken by God Himself. That is real. Is that all right? Chant Hare Krishna.